CNA today.
Okay.
And today I would like to turn you on your side. You've been on your back for quite some time.
Sounds good.
Sounds good?
Mm-hmm.
How about if we turn you on your left side?
Okay.
All right. So what I'm going to do is I am going to clean my hands and get my supplies and I will be right back.
Sounds good.
All right. So I'm going to clean my hands. And I'm thinking about the supplies I need. I am going to take a barrier towel and three pillows. And I'm going to grab those carefully and keep them away from my uniform. I'm going to flip this over here and put down my barrier towel. And I'm going to put it down lengthwise so I can... Whoops! There goes my cup. I'll have to pick that up. And I'm putting this down so I can get my pillows right on this barrier here. Alright, now that I have my supplies, I am going to do my two bed items, which are I'm going to lock my brakes and raise my bed up. So I'm going to check all four brakes, make sure these don't fall. And this brake looks like these are good. I'm going to raise my bed up using good body mechanics. There we go. And I'm going to pull my privacy curtain, which I'll leave it open now just so you can see a little better. Okay, Mr. Tim, in order to move you or to turn you on your left side, I have to move you over in segments, move your whole body over to the side of the bed. Otherwise, you'd end up way too close to that side of the bed, okay?
Sounds good.
Okay, so I'm going to move you over in thirds. What I'm going to do, just roll this down a little bit. I'm going to go underneath your shoulders and underneath your midsection here. And I am just going to gently adjust you over to the side. Then I'm going to go over to your midsection here and underneath your thighs. And I'm going to gently, you can see my bed is moving a little bit. It must not be totally locked. And I'm going to go under here and move this section over. How's that feel?
Good.
Okay. What I'm going to do now is to turn you on your left side. And before I do that, I'd like an observer. Could I have an observer, please? All right. I'd like to have you help me raise this leg here. And we're going to put your arm out just to your side because I don't want you laying on it there when we roll you over. I'm going to turn you over. Right away, I'm going to check your airway. How are you doing, Tim? Are you breathing okay?
I'm good.
Okay. So that's my first asterisk item was asking for my observer. The second asterisk item is making sure that Tim's airway is okay. And the third is to place your three pillows correctly. So I'm going to take my first pillow. I'm going to kind of dig it into the bed there and make a little roll out of it. And then I'm going to have Tim just lay back ever so gently to keep that in place. My second pillow, I'm going to place between his knees and his ankles to make sure that they aren't touching, so there's no bony prominences hitting each other. And I'm going to come over and cover him up a little bit. Now my third pillow, I'm going to go over. If I could have the observer just out of the way a little bit, I'm going to go underneath his shoulder and gently adjust him so he's not laying right flat on his shoulder. I'm not going to be tugging his arm. I'm just going to be going under his shoulder and gently adjusting that just a little bit. I'm going to take my third pillow and I'm going to lay it underneath his elbow, making sure it's supporting his elbow and his hand. And I'm going to cover him up, make sure that he's nice and cozy. How does that feel?
Good.
Looks like his body is in pretty good alignment there. I'm going to go back and put the bed down. I'm going to put my barrier towel into the dirty linens. Now you can see he's on his side, so I have to bring the overbed table over to him so that he can reach his call light and his water. I'm going to adjust this so it's at a good height for him. Here you go, Mr. Tim. Here is your call light and your water. Is there anything else I can get for you?
I'm good.
You're good? Okay. Then I would open the privacy curtain. sanitize my hands, and I'm done. As an alternative, if you are going to turn a resident on their side, I could turn him now that I have him moved over and ask for an observer to be on that side. Or as an alternative, you can turn him yourself by moving to the opposite side of the bed. So if I wanted to turn him by myself, I already have him moved over to the side of the bed. I would make sure that my pillows were close enough that I can reach them from the opposite side of the bed. Then I would go to this side of the bed. I would go underneath the covers here. I'm going to, again, lift this leg, put his arm out to make sure he doesn't lay on it, and I would turn him over. That way, I can turn him by myself, and I would then place the three pillows just as I did before by planting the pillows, making sure I have a nice roll, rolling him back on it slightly. I would take my second pillow. Again, I do have to check his airway. That is one of the asterisk items to make sure that he's breathing okay. I would put the second pillow in between his knees and his heels, making sure that nothing hits, no bony prominences are hitting each other. I would take the third pillow. I'm going to adjust his shoulder. Again, I'm going to gently go underneath his shoulder and adjust it ever so slightly. I'm not pulling on the arm. I'm using two hands to adjust the shoulder. I'm going to take the third pillow, put this lengthwise underneath his elbow and his hands. Then I'm going to make sure he's nice and warm. How you doing, Tim?
I'm good.
Are you comfortable?
Absolutely.
You look like you're in pretty good alignment there.
Ready for a nap.
Ready for a nap. All right. Well, I better get out of here then. All right. So he's all nice and comfortable. And then I would go ahead and lower the bed.